Welcome to final BSc statistics students. In paper 6 in unit 3, the lesson 2, we discuss advantages of acceptance sampling plans, disadvantages of acceptance sampling plans, and applications of acceptance sampling plans. These three topics we try to explain. Now come first of all advantages of acceptance sampling plans. Before starting this particular topic, I explain what is 100% inspection and what is the acceptance sampling plan. In 100% inspection, we inspect all the items in the lot. All the items in the lot. What is meant by lot? Lot is nothing but the total number of items produced in a particular day. For example, by a company. If a company produces 1000 items in a particular day, 1000 bikes in a particular day, then the lot is 1000 bikes. Now the sample. Sample is nothing but out of 1000 bikes produced by a company, if you want to test some particular a group of 10 items or 20 items, then those 10 or 20 items drawn at regular intervals of time is nothing but a sample. Based on the sample number of items, if you inspect the sample number of items, then that is nothing but acceptance sampling plan. By keeping these two points in mind, now you read and study all the advantages, disadvantages and applications. Because it is a comparison between acceptance sampling plan and 100% inspection. Acceptance sampling plans are always to be compared with 100% inspection. Therefore, you have to remember those two points, 100% inspection and acceptance sampling plans. Now come and discuss the advantages of acceptance sampling plans. First advantage, less expensive. Acceptance sampling plans are less expensive since less inspection. Because we are doing the less number of items, we are inspecting less number of items, therefore it is less expensive. What is acceptance sampling plans? We are inspecting less number of items. For example, out of 100 items, we are inspecting only 5 items. The sample of 5 items. Therefore, in the 100% inspection, we have to inspect 100 items. Whether they are meeting the specification, whether the product is accepting or rejecting based on the some standards. Now, whereas in the acceptance sampling plan, we are considering only 5 items, that is in the sample. We are inspecting only the 5 items, whether they are defective or not defective. Defective or non-defective, that is good or bad. Good items or bad items. That is based on the sample. So, in the acceptance sampling plans, we are inspecting less number of items, so therefore it is less expensive. The first point. First point is less expensive. The second one, reduced damage. Damage is going to be reduced. Why? Again, the same particular point but in different manner. Handling the operators, handling the product is very less. That is less handling the product. Because of the less handling the product, the damage is going to be reduced. In the acceptance sampling plant, we are handling only the less number of items. Why? Because again, for example, in a lot consists of 100 items, in the 100% inspection, we have to do all 100 items. We have to inspect all 100 items. We have to handle. Here the meaning of handling is nothing but to inspect the item, whatever the kind of handling we are doing, we do. That is nothing but handling. For the purpose of inspection only. For the purpose of inspection, in 100% inspection, we have to handle all 100 items. Whereas in the acceptance sampling plan, if you handle very less number of items, which enough to handle the number of items in the sample, that is in the entire lot taken into the sample. Therefore, damage will be reduced. To the maximum extent, damage will be reduced. That is the second point. The second point is reduced damage. Damage will be reduced because of the less handling the product in the lot. Less handling the product in the lot as compared to the 100% inspection. Third one, testing is destructive. Testing is destructive. That is some kind of items which are destructive in nature. Some kind of items, manufactured items, are destructive in nature. For example, chemicals, explosives, like oil, etc. Explosives or crackers, like medicine, etc. Which are the items which are destructive in nature. For example, if you want to test 100% inspection for all the items, in this case, that is the items which are destructive in nature, destructive items, then there will not be, if you do 100% inspection, then there will not be no particular item remains at the end of the testing procedures, inspecting procedures. So therefore, 100% inspection is not at all feasible. In the case of testing is destructive. If you take a particular chemical, if you test the entire chemical which is produced in a day by a company, then there will not be no single piece of chemical which remain at the end of the testing, at the end of the day. Therefore, 100% inspection is not at all desirable, is not at all practically, it should not be considered. Only the option is acceptance sampling plan. By taking some part of the population, that is lot, from the lot of items, we have to consider few items randomly, and then we have to inspect those items and the final picture of the lot. Whether the lot is going to be accepted or rejected is going to be decided. The disposition of the lot is going to be taken from the sample number of items. And such kind of inspection is acceptance sampling plan. Whereas 100% inspection, the testing is destructive. It is not feasible. The items which are destructive in nature is not at all going to be considered, is not at all desirable, is not at all practicable, is not at all right, correct, is not at all correct. That is third point. Testing is destructive. The third point. one less expensive, reduced, two reduced damage, three testing is destructive, and the third one reduces inspection error, fourth one reduces inspection error. What is inspection error? An error involves in inspecting a particular item, examining a particular item. Any kind of error involves in examining the item, inspecting the item. Such kind of error is known as inspection error. For example, we are doing 100% inspection. That is, we are inspecting all items randomly, all items, by considering all items, not randomly, considering all items and inspecting all items one after another. Whatever the interest we pay of inspecting first particular item and attention we pay on the inspecting a particular first item and second item, third item, fourth item, fifth item, the same kind of attention will not be there at the end of the last items. For example, 100 items are there. After some 20-30 items, the kind of attention will be reduced. We do not consider same kind of attention. We don't pay same kind of attention of inspecting the 30th item, 40th item, 50th item, etc. If you go to the at the end, maybe half of the, even half of the attention may not be paid. So therefore may not be there because of reason, the manual reasons, because of the personal reasons. Nobody is exactly attention is not possible to pay of the first at of whatever it is paying at first for first item. May not be possible to pay the same kind of attention for the last item. So therefore, so some kind of error is involved from one to another, second to third, third to fourth, etc., one to another. If you go at the end, obviously more error will be involved in the inspection of the items. That is called inspection error. From first item to the last item, the error will be more in the part of inspection, in doing the inspection. Such kind of error which is involved in the inspecting the items of the lot is nothing but inspection error. It will be more in the 100% inspection. Hope you understand. It will be more in 100% inspection, but whereas if you consider a part of the population, part of the lot, that is some number of items, sample number of items taken from the lot, a few items, for example 5 or 6 items we have drawn from the lot, and if you want to inspect it, we can definitely inspect all the items by reducing the maximum amount of inspection of error. We can pay same kind of attention for all 5 or 6 items which were drawn from the lot. Therefore, the maximum amount of inspection error can be reduced in the acceptance sampling plans. Therefore, maximum amount of inspection error can be reduced in the acceptance sampling plans rather than the 100% inspection. It is not possible in 100% inspection, whereas in the acceptance sampling plan, it is possible to a great extent, the maximum extent. These are the four advantages of acceptance sampling plans. I repeat again. One, less expensive. Two, reduced damage. Three, testing is destructive. Four, reduces the maximum amount of inspection error. Keep these points in mind so that you can easily recollect the advantages of acceptance sampling plans. Now come to the disadvantages. What are the disadvantages of acceptance sampling plans? One, there are some kinds of risks. Which can be observed from by accepting bad lots, and rejecting good lots. What is meant by accepting bad lots? For example, you consider 100 items in the lot. We have inspected 5 items randomly in the sample. That is, in the sample we have considered 5 items and we have inspected those 5 items. In which the 5 items we are getting no particular defective item. For example, no defective item was observed in whatever selected 5 items in the sample from the lot. That is, remaining 95 items were not tested. Only the 5 items were tested in which 0 number of defective items we obtained, we got. That is, no particular, after examination, no single defective items we obtained. Therefore, but in the remaining 95 items, we have more number of defective items. In testing, whatever the items we have considered, which are all not defective items, but in remaining 95 items, we have many number of defective items. That is, more number of defective items as per the guidelines given by the company. Therefore, actually the lot is bad because of the remaining 95 items. We have many number of defective items, but in our inspection we got lot is good. But as the remaining 95 items, we have many number of items are defective items. Therefore, lot is bad. The bad lot is going to be considered there. So therefore, now we are accepting the bad lot. Why? Because in our testing, it was proved that there are less number of defective items. But in the lot, we have more number of defective items. Based on the 5 items, testing based on the 5 items we have taken and we have tested, no particular defective item was discovered. In our examination, 0 number of defective items were obtained. Whereas if you consider the lot, remaining lot, it consists of more number of defective items. Hope you understand the sequence. So that is, we are accepting the bad lot based on our acceptance sampling plans. Based on the sampling test procedures, that is, inspecting the sample, we got the result as a good lot. But the lot is bad, so we are accepting the bad lot. Similarly, there may be a chance. The chance is very less, of course. But there are some less probability. Right? Then rejecting the good lot, which means whatever we have considered, whatever we have taken, the respective number of items from the lot to sample, the examining items in the acceptance sampling procedures, for example, 5 items. We have more number of defective items. For example, 3 out of 5 are defective items. But there are no defective items in the remaining 95 items. So there is a possibility. In the remaining 95 items, we have no defective item. But whereas in the consideration of whatever we have taken the sample number of 5 items, we have more number of defective items. That is, three defective items. So based on this particular 3 defective items out of 5, therefore we are rejecting the lot. Based on our information. But whereas the lot is good, why? The remaining 95 items, it consists of no defective item. Therefore, lot is good. The good lot is going to be rejected. based on our information. It is possible and it happens only in rare cases. That is need not be considered always it is going to be happen. No, that is the reason why we are inspecting, we are considering the items at regular intervals of time. Without happening this, that is to avoid this particular possibility, to avoid the risk which is consisting of accepting the bad lot and rejecting the good lot. Only we are inspecting, we are considering at regular intervals of time. We are considering the sample number of items at regular intervals of time. We don't consider by 10 o'clock, we don't consider all 5 or all 10, whatever the sample number of items. Such kind of procedure is not going to be accepted. It's not there in the acceptance sampling plans or in any kind of statistical quality control techniques. So therefore, to avoid this, to reduce any kind of risk among these kind of points, we are considering that the samples at regular intervals of time period. By 8, we consider one item. By 9 o'clock, we consider the second item. 10 o'clock, another item. 11 o'clock, another two items, etc. We consider at regular intervals of time, for every 20 minutes, every 30 minutes, we consider one item. 8, one particular item. 8:30, another item. 9, another item. 9:30, another item, etc. Such kind of principles we are applying. So therefore, there is no possibility, no chance of happening this, but even then, there is some kind of risk. May be observed. This is one of the disadvantages of acceptance sampling plans. Second one, less information is generated because of we are dealing with some number of items only from the lot. Only 3%, 4% or 5% items only we are inspecting out of 100 items or out of 1000 items, whatever it may be. It is produced in a particular day. So therefore, we are considering a particular very less number of items we are handling, we are inspecting. Therefore, we are getting less information. Less information is only usually generated in the acceptance sampling plans, whereas in the 100% inspection, we get the information regarding each and every item. We get the information and we can provide the information regarding every item, each and every item, because of the 100% inspection. In 100% inspection, we do and we examine, we test each and every particular item. We inspect each and every particular item. But whereas in the acceptance sampling plans, we consider only very few items, 5% or 6% or 4% items only we consider out of total number of items in the lot. Therefore, less information only generated in the acceptance sampling plans. This is one of the another disadvantages of acceptance sampling plan. Third one, planning and documentation. Planning and documentation. Acceptance sampling plan requires planning and documentation, whereas 100% inspection does not require it. Does not require any planning, any documentation. Why? We are inspecting all items. In 100% inspection, we are inspecting all items. In acceptance sampling plans, we have to inspect only few items, 5%, 4% items only we are considering at regular intervals of time. That is the reason why we have to plan. What is meant by planning? So one such planning is nothing but we have to consider at regular intervals of time. We have to consider a particular item at regular intervals of time. Every half an hour we have to consider one item or two items randomly. like that some particular rules are going to be framed which must be planned and then documentation is also must be provided, must be taken, that is also must be done. Based on these two particular planning and documentation, proper planning, proper documentation only gives a best execution of acceptance sampling plans. Otherwise, acceptance sampling plan itself, it speaks, it's a one particular kind of plan. Therefore, acceptance sampling plan, in the execution of acceptance sampling plans, it requires a proper planning and documentation. Whereas, for 100% inspection, it does not require. No need to have any kind of planning and documentation. These are the some of the main disadvantages of acceptance sampling plans. The advantages and disadvantages. Now come to the part of applications. Applications of acceptance sampling plans. Applications where we apply these acceptance sampling plans. Acceptance sampling plans can be applied. First one, testing is destructive. Destructive testing. Testing is destructive. Just we have discussed it. The third advantage. Testing is destructive. That is, in such a case, only one and only one application we can apply is acceptance sampling plan. We cannot apply in the destructive nature. The items which are in destructive nature, we cannot apply 100% inspection. If you want to inspect, if you want to examine whether the item is defective or not defective, that can be done only through only acceptance sampling plans. That is, this is one of the very important application, because the testing is destructive, the item will not, if you do 100% inspection of the items which in the nature of the destructive nature, which in the nature of destructive, then 100% inspection is not at all practically feasible and possible. It is not at all correct, it is not at all good. So therefore, in this case, only acceptance sampling plans can only apply. Acceptance sampling plans only can be applied in this kind of testing is destructive. Second one, it is more, 100% inspection is more expensive. 100% inspection. The cost of 100% inspection. The cost of 100% inspection. It is more. For example, if we are doing a particular some kind of examination, inspection. If you want to do the 100% inspection, the cost of 100% inspection is more rather than producing the item. To produce a particular item, for example, it costs at around of 1,000 rupees. Then to inspect the item, it takes the cost of 100 rupees or 200 rupees. Then obviously, the cost of 100% inspection, that is cost of inspecting all the items, will be more. So therefore, the company may not bear. So such kind of cost, such amount of cost. So therefore, obviously, there is no particular option. They have to go for acceptance sampling plans. The cost of the 100% inspection is, if it is more in any particular company, then even though the time permits, the cost is more for inspecting all the items, then only one option is nothing but acceptance sampling plans. That is, inspecting some number of items. Inspecting some sample number of items. That is the second one. Third one. What is the third one? 100% inspection is not practically feasible. So even though the cost is lesser, that means this is a controversial statement. That is some kind of statement which is not related to this. That is, other than here it is cost of the 100% inspection is high, what we are specifying. Now, here in this case, we are explaining that the 100% inspection is not practically feasible. Even though the 100% inspection is possible, but it is not practically feasible. That is, it is not practically correct. It is not practically good. So the testing of all the items, it is not practically correct. And then in such a case, 100% inspection is only one and only other way of inspecting the items. When in a case, 100% inspection is not practically feasible, then only the option is acceptance sampling plans. Next, the fourth one. Fourth application. If you are doing more number of items, if you are testing or inspecting more number of items, if more number of items are to be inspected, then amount of inspection error will be very high. Then 100 inspection error will be very high. In which case, if you want to inspect more number of items, many number of items, if the many number of items are to be inspected, when many number of items are going to be inspected, in such a case, inspection error will be very high, sufficiently very high. So obviously, that's what we are explaining, that I have explained that 100% inspection involves more and more inspection error than the acceptance sampling plans. The 100% inspection involves and it creeps maximum amount of inspection error. So therefore, if you want to do more number of items, if more number of items are inspected, then inspection error will be more. It is